Greater Reading ACT UP on BCTV is supported by the Greater Reading Alliance of Community Theatres.
Yeah, hello, and welcome to Greater Reading ACT UP. My name's Pat Perfect. I'm your hostess for this evening, this afternoon, whatever time this might be airing, since we're not going to be showing our regular Wednesday evenings because the Royals are playing. So we wish them the best of luck. We're going to have a rambunctious show today, moving through several different theaters locally who are doing Christmas shows. And unfortunately, our newspaper does not have the wherewithal currently to feature information about these wonderful shows and great local talent that are going to be helping us celebrate the holidays. The first show we're going to start off with is being done by Reading Community Players. It's called Postmortem. And we have some actors here that are going to be on stage starting this Friday. Ruth, Nicole, and Bill. And so anyway, I'm going to turn it over to you guys and find out what's going on. Where are you performing?
We're performing in the George Bear Chapel of the what used to be most recently the Hopewell Mennonite Church at 6th and Cherry, although it runs to, 6th and Franklin?
Yes.
So it's a block-long church. It's absolutely beautiful. It's currently under renovations. So we're going to do the best we can in a lovely space with a whole bunch of talent.
Yeah, and where do you hail from, Nicole? You're from out of town, I believe.
A little bit. I'm from the Lehigh Valley. I grew up in Easton, Pennsylvania, and that's where I am right now.
Okay. Yeah. And what character do you play?
I play Louise Paradine, and she's quite an interesting character. She's a lot of thoughts, and she brings a lot into the space. So she hasn't seen her friends in a while. So she's coming back into
it's a happy reunion.
It's a reunion.
It's a reunion. I don't know about happy, but it's a reunion.
Okay. Well, there's some clues. Yes. What might be afoot? And how are you, Mr. Bill?
I'm very good, Pat.
Okay.
I play William Gillette, so it's very easy for me to remember my character's name. He is a real person, but this is not a real story. Ken Ludwig used him to set this story around. He was a very famous author, playwright, and actor in the early days of American theater. Best known for portraying Sherlock Holmes. In fact, he actually helped Conan Doyle work on the stage version of Sherlock Holmes, which he then played Sherlock. He also played in the early silent films, but was replaced later when talkies came around. So the story basically goes, and again, this is fictional, William Gillette's girlfriend is killed at his house, the Gillette Castle, which has been a real place. The murder remains unsolved. A year to the day, he invites the people who were staying in the castle that night back, in hopes of finding who the killer was out of this group of people that he invited back.
There's one new guest, somebody who was not present the year before. And after the death was ruled a suicide. And I guess Gillette's goal is to prove that that might not be true. People can go see Gillette's castle.
It's
open to the public. It's in Haddam, Haddam, Connecticut.
Oh, okay. So it's in the United States.
Absolutely.
I don't know why. I was thinking it was in Europe, in England.
It could be because it's a gorgeous, gorgeous castle. It's beautiful.
He's so intriguing, Pat. Anybody who sees this, look him up. He was brilliant in a lot of different fields. So
Well, now who do you play, Ruth? Oh, I forgot the answer. Who do you play?
What else would I play but an old lady? I'm typecast. I play Aunt Lily, who's kind of, she's either really sophisticated and in charge of everything or slightly mad. It can be played either way, and folks will just have to come and see to find out how it's being played in this show.
That sounds great. And how much are tickets, and where can we get tickets?
They can be bought at the door. They can be bought online at readingcommunityplayers.com,
I believe.
Seniors and students, 15. Adults, 20.
Oh, okay.
So it's a relatively inexpensive trip, date. Gift. You name it.
That depends, I guess, if you want to go out to dinner or do something like that.
Well, here's something really interesting. We're right up the block from the Ugly Oyster.
Oh, okay.
And not that far from the Doubletree, and probably not that far from either Judy on Cherries or the Peanut Barn.
Right, and there is parking.
Mm-hmm. Yes, plenty of parking.
All right.
Yes.
In the lot across the street from the Ugly Oyster.
Okay. And also right across from the church, I think I remember, right across from 6th Street, go up 6th Street, make a left, make another left, and then you're in a parking lot. Pretty sure that's...
Yeah, it's right behind the church. I believe that parking lot is behind the church. Yep.
Okay. Well, parking's always an issue in Reading, isn't it?
So, but it shouldn't keep you from coming out, boys and girls.
No, it looks like it's going to be a fun show. And along the lines of Clue and the mystery things. And it's funny, too, isn't it?
Yes. Yes.
I mean, it's not morose.
Yeah.
We're doing Christmas here. Yeah.
Now, no jingle bells will be sung. but it's a Christmas show because it's happening in December. And you're all welcome to come and solve the mystery, because I think audience members will make their best guess at intermission.
Oh, yes. Isn't that exciting? And so we're going to vote for who we think?
Yeah. Yes.
When did we do that before? Murder In.
Yes. Exactly.
Yes, Murder In, I remember. And they never guessed the right people, did they?
No. A few of them did. But anyway, join us.
Yes, please join us. Come and check out the show. It runs Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Do you have two shows or just one?
No, just one show in the afternoon.
One show in the afternoon. When's the curtain?
7:30 on Friday and Saturday.
Okay.
And then 3
and
o'clock.
Sunday.
3 o'clock on Sunday.
3.
3 o'clock. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think I'm going to be checking out the matinee.
Oh, wonderful.
Thank you for this opportunity to get the news about theater out into the ether.
Yes, well, we need to do that because we used to be able to count on the newspaper to help us get the word out and do a little promotion, a little picture, a little blurb. Mm-hmm. Everybody had some idea of what was going on. So I think it's just been wonderful to have you guys here.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for the opportunity.
And we'll come and see you at the Bear Church.
George,
that sounds weird.
George Bear Church. Chapel.
Yeah.
At church.
At 6th and Cherry. 6th
and Cherry.
Hey, okay. Thank you. Just quickly, thank you to BCTV for giving us the opportunity to spread the word about our shows. Yeah. If it weren't for you, we get nothing. And thank you, Pat, for making sure that this is possible.
Oh, you're very welcome. It's been my pleasure, and I'm looking forward to, I think our next guest up is Brian Fichtorn from Genesius, who has a show that's opening this coming weekend also. So we're trying to get this in chronological order for folks so that you can sort of plan things out. All right. So thank you. Guys, don't forget your microphones.
Don't walk away
with the equipment.
Yeah.
Because we love BCTV. We don't want anything to happen bad to the equipment or the TV station or anything.
Okay, so, I'm out of here.
All right. Thanks a lot. And as they perform for us around the community. That's Postmortem, nice little flyer up there. I hope you get an opportunity to check the show out. GRAC, the Alliance for Community Theaters, is going to be writing a letter to the publishers of the newspaper to see if we can encourage them to offer us more local involvement with the theaters, movie theaters, things like that, so that we can once again feel like the community knows what the community theater is doing. And this is Brian Fichtorn.
Hello.
And he's from Genesius. He's the president of Genesius, and he's going to talk to us about
The Little Mermaid. We have The Little Mermaid opening this Friday. Disney's The Little Mermaid, so we've got this great family show with full orchestra and this great cast, and it's really exciting.
We open. Where are you performing? Are you performing at your theater on 10th Street?
We're at 10th and Walnut Street, 153 North 10th Street. It's where we perform. We have free parking next to the theater. We just get there early enough and get a space, and you'll have no problem. So we have performances on Friday, this coming Friday evening through the following Sunday.
Okay, so you're running the show 2 weekends.
That's correct.
And, okay, and what are the
one
times?
Week night. All right. And one week night on Wednesday night, right. Mm-hmm.
Which Wednesday now,
the,
Brian?
We open this Friday,
okay,
and then
so
the following Wednesday,
that's
correct.
Okay.
So all of the evening performances, that is Friday, Saturday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, all of the evening performances are at 7:30 p.m.
Okay.
Okay. And we have matinees. We have 2 o'clock matinees on the Saturdays, the two Saturdays, and we have 3 o'clock matinees on the two Sundays.
Okay. All right, that's interesting that they're different times on
that's
the
correct.
Matinees.
Well, the reason we do that is because when we have an evening performance, we make sure the matinee is scheduled a little bit earlier so the cast has a break.
Yeah,
so
has time to recuperate.
Exactly.
Yes.
Right. Exactly.
It's a very energizing show, I'm sure.
It is, yes, it is. So it's going to be really cool.
Uh-huh. So now, how many do you have, like, Ursula and all the characters?
We have all the Disney characters, all the traditional characters, and it's really great. It's selling really well, too. So.
Oh, that's good.
So we're excited.
Yeah, it's a good show. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a family show. Mm-hmm. And I guess everybody is probably going to be singing along. Do you expect?
I would say so.
Yeah, maybe.
I would say so. We have something else cool going on too, because we have a pre-show party.
Oh, okay. Tell us about that.
Well, let's see. As I read from my press release here, we have it's a separately ticketed pre-show party with the main characters. It's Ariel, Prince Eric, Sebastian, Scuttle, Flounder, and Ursula on the matinee dates. It's an hour before the matinees, so what you would do is go on our website, and then you would pay separately for that. So party participants can enjoy a craft activity, play games, have a snack, get their photo taken with the characters. All ages are invited, but it's geared toward children 3 to 10 years old. So it's an added extra touch that goes with the show.
Yeah, cool. No, that's very nice. Mm-hmm. And then I guess they'll have an opportunity to have their pictures taken with the actors, with the characters,
that's
and things
correct.
Like
mm-hmm.
that.
Yep.
So that's wonderful. And besides right around the theater, which I know you do have parking, mm-hmm. where is more parking available for people?
Well, there is street parking, of course.
Uh-huh.
But what we tell people is basically come to the theater, come to our lot. If there's no parking spaces in the lot, we rent spaces at a lot that's just a block away. So
okay.
what we would do is we would direct to you how to get to that lot.
Oh, okay.
And we give you a parking permit for the lot.
Uh-huh.
And so that's very easy, and so you'll have no problem getting a space.
Okay, and then what are the prices for the tickets?
The prices for the tickets are anywhere from $17.50 for students, $22.50 for seniors, $28.50 for adults. There is also premium seating, like front rows and aisle seating, which is a little bit higher.
Okay, and then the pre-party. How much are the pre-party tickets?
The pre-party tickets are, oh God, off the top of my head. I don't have that on the top of my head. I want to say something like around $10, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not that much.
Okay. Mm. Now, that sounds like an odd question. If you go to the pre-party, does that mean you go to the show too?
We have to pay. We hope you'll buy a ticket for the show too.
Oh, okay. So. Well, not to be sticky wicked or anything like that. I was just sort of curious.
That's okay.
Somebody could come in and hang out with Ariel or whatever, and then be off. You know. So, are we ready to move to the next show? Is that what? No. Okay. I'm sorry. Pardon me. I'm. Oh, $15 a person?
I actually think we took the
oh, okay.
I think we took it down since
Thank
that
Thank you
ad
very
came out,
much. But. If, you know.
But you'll see online. It's on the
okay.
ticket site.
Okay, go right. online. Mm-hmm. I think that's what they're showing right now on the TVs.
www.geniciusdifference.org is our website.
Okay.
Where you can pick your seats and pay for your tickets.
Okay.
That's how it comes out, too.
Oh, that's really, so you can actually go and see your seating arrangement.
Right,
and
that's
pick
what you
that.
Do. Because we're a small theater, we only seat 100 people.
Uh-huh.
So all seats are assigned and sold.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Well, that's a good idea.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some of the performances are already sold out, I believe. In fact, I just went online. I think Friday night sold out. So,
and that's your opening. So
yeah,
that's always
correct.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
It's always great to have a full house on an opening.
I know,
night.
It is.
Yeah. So I don't know if there's anything else you want to share with us?
About The Little Mermaid? I don't think so. Just come and see the show.
Okay. Now, do you have kids in this show?
Yes, we do. Lots of kids.
Mm-hmm. Lots of kids?
Yes,
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
kids
are they in lead roles?
They're in... you know, I don't know.
Oh, you don't know.
I would say probably. Off the top of my head, I don't recall who all is in what role.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. So mm-hmm. Do we have any more pictures from The Little Mermaid? I know that we were looking at some on the... Oh, okay. There you have it.
There's a shot.
Ariel.
Okay. Yep. Mm-hmm.
That's nice. And who is she? Do you know her?
I believe
who
that's
the actress is?
Emily. I believe that's Emily. So.
Well,
and
anyway.
then below, if you go below that, you'll see another picture.
Oh, okay.
But I don't know if the person who's.
All right. Well, with the full orchestra, mm-hmm. Where'd you get that?
Well, it's local people for the most part.
Okay.
So we have people that play in our pit on a regular basis.
And
we use full orchestras too. We don't skimp. Our musical supervisor hires the musicians, and they play in other local theaters too. In fact, a lot of people that play in Effort is EPAC.
Okay.
A lot
yeah.
of people that play in EPAC in their pit play in our pit.
Okay.
As is true also with a lot of actors. A lot of our actors are also you also see on the stage at Effort and other surrounding theaters.
Uh huh. Yeah.
So the local theater company is pretty ingrained and.
We certainly share all mm-hmm. the talent. We certainly share all the. Audiences, and mm-hmm. Another good reason why we should have a community theater. So I want to thank you very much
okay.
for coming on TV
and
sharing
you.
The news, mm-hmm. and I hope you have a wonderful run.
Thank
and,
you.
And I hope to see you at the next GRAC meeting.
We will be there.
Okay.
Okay.
Very good. And I believe Susan Roan from the Yocum Institute is up next. She's going to share with us about their production of Christmas Carol. So
okay,
all we're right. moving right along here. Thanks a lot. Mm-hmm. I hope that everybody is aware that out there in our little green room that it's time for Susan. So tag team event. oh, be careful there. So this is sort of different because we just didn't have a newspaper to publicize all the things that are going on for us here in the community in community theater. And really, community theater would not exist without community information. So that's another reason why we're very pleased and happy that BCTV has been so generous for us in getting this information out and stuff. Do you need some help there?
Am I wondering?
Oh, I think that'll
work. You're
going to
hear me?
I believe so.
Okay. Just
all right.
checking.
Yeah, hey. This
checking.
Is Susan Roan. She's the director of the Yocum Institute that's out in West Lawn. Mm-hmm. And tell us about your show, what you're doing.
Well, we have a Christmas Carol coming up. Did they get the...
Yeah, I imagine they have the something from the internet. I know that they just put it up for Genesius. But why don't you tell us about
well,
your show?
Well, anyway, the show pretty much follows the book.
Uh-huh.
It's a cast of 35, and they're from Berks and even Lancaster County, and there's some professionals and some people there we've never worked with before.
Uh-huh.
And it's
that's exciting.
Brilliant. It is exciting. And we have... a live music, Christmas carolers, all live. A live fiddler. We found a fiddler.
Oh, wow.
And
good.
It really is going to be a great show. Uh-huh. I really think it is. And it opens Thursday, December 12th at 7 o'clock. And then there's shows Friday at 8 o'clock at night. And then Saturday at 2 in the afternoon. And then another one at 8. Now, there's a possibility there will be a Sunday show, but we're not sure yet.
Okay. Are you going to wait to see how your houses are or advance ticket sales?
Part of that. And the other thing is, if you get bad weather one night, you can reschedule then for Sunday. You have that open slot.
Oh, okay. I see. That's very thoughtful thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially this time of year, since we were supposed to have a snowstorm. It hit farther north, up there in Lehigh Valley, it hit. So anyway, we got off easy so far, knock on wood.
Thank goodness.
Yeah. So tell them the address of the Yocum.
Oh, it's 3000 Penn Avenue.
Okay. Yes,
they moved. It used to be on Belmont Avenue.
Right.
But now we are on 3000 Penn Avenue on West Lawn.
Okay.
Lots of parking, but always remember to park on the Institute's parking lot.
Oh, yeah?
Only.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Have people gotten confused in
the
past?
They get confused because you can be past the parking lot. The parking lot, if you're coming from Wyomissing area, if you're going west, the parking lot is before the building.
Okay.
So that's where you have to enter.
Okay.
Right,
so we'll take note of
the
that.
Building. Mm-hmm.
All right. And the ticket prices?
I believe they're $10 and $12.
Okay.
Yes. I think $10 in advance or for members.
Okay.
$12, I believe, at the door, or $15 at the door, and $12 if you're a non-member.
Okay. And then let's see. What did I want to ask you? Oh, you have all these people, okay? Mm-hmm. And how many seats do you have in your little theater?
Well, when we did Poe's Unhappy Hour, we actually had 180 people in there because the schools came in.
Oh, okay.
And we were crazy with the one. There were 180. So we used every seat in the house and the building.
Okay.
Yeah, we were okay.
That's good.
So we can seat about that.
Yeah.
Depending.
And Christmas Carol is one of my favorite stories of all times. I've done it many times, especially at Christmas time. Of course, how can you not do it at Christmas time? Although it could be a Halloween show with all the ghosts that are floating around in it. You're looking forward to seeing it.
Yes, we are looking forward to it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. No, and a fiddler too, huh?
Fiddler and live carolers, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, it should be. Mm-hmm. It probably will be a lot of fun.
Maybe it'll become a tradition.
Oh, well, that would be interesting. Mm-hmm. You do have a couple traditions that you sort of do at the Yocum, don't you?
Sometimes, yes.
Yeah,
Yeah, like we used to have it, yeah. It varies.
Yeah.
It varies, yes, we do have some traditions. We always have Broadway Junior in the summer.
Uh-huh.
And we're creating a new kind of schedule because we've been in the building a year, a little over a year now. So we're trying to, you know, we're learning as we go along.
That's great.
Uh-huh.
Congratulations on your anniversary.
Yes, we made it.
Yeah. No, that's great. First year is usually the hardest, huh?
Well, it's a lot of transition.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, just learning as you go along.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what we've had to do.
Yeah.
But there are two parking lots there, an upper and a lower.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So I think there's 90 or 100 spaces.
Okay, that sounds like that'll help to be, you know, especially if people join together and come in, you know, one vehicle or whatever. Pull the cars together, you know.
I thought you were going to get a bus.
Oh, a bus.
I thought you were driving.
Oh, no. I stopped driving the bus when I gave up my state job.
Well, I thought maybe you'd do that and you could just transport all these patrons.
That'd be fun.
Yeah, it would
a
be.
Trolley.
We could have a little party on the bus.
Yeah, we could have them. Yeah, okay. Sometime. Well, we'll have to.
We'll think about that.
Yeah, but
But thank you for inviting us on.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
No, like I was telling our audience, I'm really happy to be able to that BCTV has given us an opportunity to do this because we're not in the newspapers, you know, and that's sort of I sort of miss it. I mean, I like the newspaper. I don't know how people feel about it, but I enjoy
I like
the newspaper.
I get three.
Oh, you get three?
Oh, sure.
Oh, wow. I could probably read another one now since the Reading Eagle has gotten thinner and thinner, it seems. But We could fatten it up, especially with this December issue.
Oh, yes.
All the shows Absolutely. That are happening. It's great.
Yes. Beth, thank you.
You're very welcome. And I guess we're ready. Now we're going to dive into, I believe, Legally Blonde. So when you go out there.
I'll get Legally Blonde in here.
Yeah. Get our Legally Blonde lady in here for us. So, yeah, if anybody out there is feeling like we're sort of feeling these days with not being able to publicize things like we would like to, please write the newspaper a letter and let them know that you miss this information in your daily newspaper. There's a Christmas Carol sign for Susan's show. So if you, we got to pinch that a little bit. Don't want to catch you in it. There you go. Thanks, Jeanette. You're all organized. Yeah, we can have our...
30 minutes left.
Okay. All right. I'll try. It says we have more time.
Oh, no.
There's nothing wrong with more time.
Yeah, more time for a night of talk.
Yeah, really. I thought I'd, I was wearing roller skates for a while, it felt like, trying to keep up with things. But this is Jeanette D'Angelo, and she's president of Reading Civic Theater. And she's also, are you the director for
Legally Blonde? No, actually, we're co-directing. For this particular show, Brandon Kegarais wanted to have a first-time shot at directing, and approached me and asked me if I would be willing to co-direct with him. And I said, absolutely. I've known Brandon for a long, long time. He went through my Reading High School program. So I've worked with him for 4 years in high school, and then he's helped me out quite a few times in doing community theater when I needed roles filled.
Oh, that's great.
And so it's been a lot of fun.
So he's an actor, too.
He's an actor. He's got a wonderful voice.
Uh-huh.
He's really, really multi-talented. He's that, like, that triple threat kind of thing because he's also a dancer. If you said something to him about dancing, he probably would say, well, not really, but movement, that kind of thing. He's great. And so it's been a really good experience. It's also been a learning experience because when you co-direct, you really have to know who's doing what part of the process.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean?
Well, yeah. Do you decide that in like a production meeting before you... even do auditions or?
Well, we kind of went right from Mamma Mia
into
Legally Blonde because in Mamma Mia, I was the director and Brandon was my assistant director. And many of us just went seriously on my creative team right from Mamma Mia into Legally Blonde. So we only had like about a week to kind of just relax and just unwind a little bit. So we really didn't have a whole lot of time to do what you just said. We did meet. We talked about, okay, well, he's going to block these scenes and I'm going to be responsible for these scenes. And then we brought in D'Angelo Urquhart, who is the choreographer. And then it was one of those, okay, well, I'll do this musical number and then whoever wants to do another musical number, that kind of thing.
Uh-huh.
And Jared Miller is our musical director. And, you know, when we brought him in, we started the process by doing the vocals first. So we did talk about who was going to do what. And I took on a lot of the producing aspect of the show, too.
Oh, okay.
And then Brandon did a lot. Of course, I worked with him, but as far as, like, helping Larry Pisano, who does the building, helping to design the set.
Uh-huh.
So it's really a team effort. Like, there's no one person who's more important.
But no, that's true. Everybody's important when you're doing a show.
Absolutely.
Everybody.
Absolutely.
And it's all vital work, because without it, you don't have a finished show.
You don't. And right now, you know, we're kind of scrambling for crew people. And, you know, the cast can't do the show. The creative team can't do the show without a crew.
Right. I mean, hey, there's somebody out there. Right. Wants to help, learn a little bit about backstage or whatever.
Right.
How could they possibly get in contact with you? You want to share some of that information?
They could, if they're on Facebook, the easiest way to do that is to contact me through private messaging on Facebook.
On Facebook, and then would just say Jeanette D'Angelo on Facebook?
I think Facebook, you just put in my name, Jeanette D'Angelo. That'll come up, and then there's a message, a private message spot. Or, you know, sadly, I don't remember the number for the theater in the building.
Right.
And I really don't want to give my cell phone number
out.
But I think the building is 610-375-8476. That would be for the RCT, Reading Civic Theater building. But you can always look it up, Google it, use an old phone book.
Oh my gosh, a phone book. I remember those.
Yeah, whatever. But, or stop in at the Miller Center next Saturday.
That's where you're doing the show,
That's
the Miller
correct.
Center.
Yes.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. So now, are they helping you with the ticket sales, or
yes.
where do people get tickets?
Well, you can purchase your tickets by calling the Miller Center box office. We're going back. We had been at the Santander Performing Arts Center for Mamma Mia, so now we're going back to the Miller Center for this particular show. And yeah, they handle all of the tickets for us. They do a great job. It's a really nice venue, and Breck Buckwalter, who's the technical director of that facility, is great to work with.
Yes, he's a wonderful
person.
Yes,
he is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Glad he came to our community.
Oh, absolutely.
He and his wife, Robin, they're great assets to our community.
Yes, we gained a lot through his being here.
Uh-huh. So now, what are the ticket prices like?
We are selling, we have two prices. We have a $30 ticket price for adults, and then we have a $25 price for students. I believe it's 12 and under that are $25, and then 65 and older.
Oh, okay.
It's $25.
Okay, $25 for students young, younger than 12 and seniors, and then $30
for adults.
For the adults, okay.
And I might be off a little bit about the 12 and under. I'm just not sure. I should have brushed up on that kind of stuff for this interview. But we've been really, really busy. The snow, the weather, and last minute situations. We've had a little bit of illness hit our cast. So.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yeah. Well, we're getting good. It's
right.
It's, you know, something that I'd rather have it this week.
Yeah,
than next week.
Yeah.
You know, the weather's kind of crazy and it's affecting people differently.
Yeah.
So you know, I apologize, but I'm pretty sure the 30 and 25 I am sure of, the 30 for adults I'm 100% sure of, but it's the 12 and under that
I question.
Yeah,
just a little uncertain about
but
the
if you
age,
call the box office, they'll tell you.
Yeah, sure. You know. I guess you could look it up. What's your website for RCT? Do you know offhand?
I believe it's readingcivictheater.org.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then you could look it up there and find out.
Yep, we do have it there.
That all that information would be available there.
Or call RAC.
Yeah, or call the Miller.
The box office.
Sure, they would be able to answer that for sure.
Yep.
And that's a wonderful venue, like you were saying. Mm-hmm. The parking is just right there. You don't need to worry about parking, which unfortunately continues to be an issue.
Yeah, no issue there.
Yeah.
It's a great, and it's about a 495-seat theater. And you can see pretty well, I think, in almost every seat. I don't sit in the seats. Usually I'm, you know, like you, when you're in a show, you're either backstage helping out.
Yeah.
And now in this particular show, I am in it. I make a couple cameo appearances because we didn't have enough people to fill some of the roles.
Well, now that's interesting. So what character do you play?
Oh, my goodness.
Okay. Are you the sorority mom that comes in?
No.
Keeps an eye on all those girls?
I keep an eye on them in the hair salon. I am a salesperson and have a little bit of a solo in that. I am the cashier. I have a little bit of a solo in that, and the bend and snap number, which I absolutely love. I'm having a great time. And then I'm the stenographer in the court.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, it's a lot
of fun.
Well,
they put you to work.
They did, yes, they did, but it's fun. It's
yeah, fun. No, I think it would be a lot of fun to sort of be able to do that, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. Because as a director or whatever, you're usually so engaged in all aspects of the production.
Oh, right, right.
That if you hadn't had someone else there, you would have had to find someone else right, to right. be able to see the whole picture. So even you as a cashier would know
right.
how you were doing.
Right, right. I will say that I think for me personally, it's very difficult to direct whether you are the director or you're co-directing and be in a show. I find that extremely difficult. Some people probably do not, but I do because I want to see what's happening. I want to be able to look at it and fine-tune it. And you can't do that if you are in the scene.
Right.
Because you're looking at it from the performer's aspect, uh-huh. which is good, but then you can't really look at it straight on.
Right.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Absolutely, because I agree with you completely. I honestly don't know how some directors can be in the show and also direct, mm-hmm. because you have to have your fourth wall so that you can see what it presents itself right. when it's on stage, because like you're saying, when you're on stage, you might have great eye contact, but terrible blocking. But if someone's not out there to tell you that, yeah. then you start to do it all the time so that it becomes ingrained, so that when the show is performing, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. you're still making little mistakes that maybe somebody could have, you know, gotten you around.
And yeah. and so we're all taking turns. Angela, D'Angelo Urquhart, who is the choreographer, is also a supporting lead. And Brandon, who is the co-director, is the male lead. So, you know, there's a lot of people.
Well, that's
that are,
almost like a tag team event.
Oh,
then.
Yeah. We're constantly taking turns watching.
Watching. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. No, because you're absolutely right. You have to have eyes on you.
Yes.
You know,
right.
so that you
right.
know what you're doing and mm-hmm. can do it well.
Right.
Oh, that's great. Well, I wish you all the... Now, Thank tell you. Us again. You open on the 12th?
No, we open actually on Friday, December 13th.
Oh, the 13th.
Right?
Okay.
And then that is a 7:30 curtain.
Okay.
Then again on Saturday the 14th, 7:30 curtain. And then Sunday the 15th is our closing performance, and that's a 2 o'clock matinee.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. That's great. Thanks
Thank you.
So much, Jeanette, for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
And you know, once again, it's great to have so many shows this year.
Yeah.
You know, last year, I don't know, last year there was one Christmas show.
Really?
And yeah. No, there wasn't this as many things going on. Mm-hmm. And so, at least for me personally, that's why the newspaper just seems so important to these
oh,
things.
Because yeah.
you get a little picture. Remember, we get mm-hmm. a little picture, mm-hmm. a little write-up, sometimes a nice longer write-up.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's I'm not sure what the newspaper is going to say to our GRAC letter,
mm-hmm.
but there's no point in not asking. If you don't ask the question, the answer is always no. But if you ask the question, maybe they'll be able to give us a protocol or a procedure, something to do
right.
so that we can get our information into the newspaper and out to the community, because you're our audience. We count on you.
Right.
You're an integral part of community theater.
I always say, nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Amen.
So what does it hurt? All they
Absolutely.
Can do is say no.
Right, and we're no better... off
right.
one way or the other, but
exactly.
if we don't ask the question, we won't ever know. Maybe they're more than willing to help us if we send them the pictures and do the write-up or whatever
right.
they might want from us. So I'm agreeable to that, huh?
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Well, thanks, Jeanette, for
thanks.
Coming on the show
thanks
with us.
Thanks for having
and,
me.
We're heading into the end of the month sort of
yeah.
here.
Into a new year very soon.
I know. I can't get over it. So everybody's getting ready for Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Christmas tickets to a community theater show would be a wonderful gift to give the family or whatever.
Yeah.
A nice afternoon or evening out, you know, dinner at Doubletree, Judy's, peanut bar, ugly oyster, wherever.
How about an escape from reality?
Yeah.
Just two and a half hours of fun.
Yeah.
Legally Blonde is all about fun, although there's a message about stereotypical concepts, you know, where everybody thinks, oh, Elle's blonde, so she can't become a lawyer because she's blonde.
Right, she's
and there's
not
no
smart
brain
enough.
In there. No. But I mean, it's just a fun show, and it's a great way to escape today's world.
Yes.
So, you know, come on out, everybody. Go see as many of the shows as you can.
Yeah, absolutely. Right? Why not?
Right.
I mean, and we're so fortunate, knock on wood, with the weather sort of like missing us here and there.
Can only hope.
Yeah, yeah. So I wish you the best.
Okay, thanks a lot.
And thank you very much. And
thank you.
When
for
you head
me.
On out to the grand room, send Miss Debbie.
You bet.
And I think that we're going to move on to Nunsense next.
Yes.
Because Fleetwood didn't make it today, did they?
I don't
they?
Know. I didn't. When I left, they weren't there.
Okay. Well, I'm just going to mention, I don't have all the details, but I want to mention that Fleetwood Community Theater is doing the greatest Christmas pageant ever. And so I think they're doing, they used to do their performances pretty much at like a church. So see if you can check that out. I imagine most things are available on the internet. Go to Fleetwood Community Theater, and maybe their homepage or their information will come up. And then can have an opportunity to check out the greatest Christmas pageant ever. So here comes my friend, Debbie Silas, and she's from Reading Community Players. And they're doing Nunsense at Penn State Berks Perkins Auditorium. And I'm got it all right so far.
You're good so far.
And then let's see, they open on December 20th. So
yes,
now take it away, sister, whatever your name is.
I am I am Reverend Mother.
Reverend Mother.
We are doing Nunsense, the mega musical. And the reason it's called the mega musical is the original Nunsense was only five nuns. This one has the original five nuns plus a father and a brother and a couple of other sisters. So it's a bigger cast than just five people. We also have some very special guests that will be joining us, but it's a surprise.
Oh, okay. So we have to come to the show to find out what the surprise is.
To greet our little special, our special guests. So we, as Pat said, we open Friday, June 20th at 7 o'clock.
Oh, no, December.
Did I say June?
Yes.
Oh, I'm
sorry. My gosh. We made it through Christmas.
I am so sorry. Oh, my God. Yes, all right.
Oh, my goodness.
So let me go back and start again. Yeah, it's called Senior Moment. We open December 20th at 7 o'clock, and then we have two shows on the 21st, one at 2 o'clock and one at 7 o'clock. The tickets are $20 for adults and $15 for seniors and for students. And it is definitely a show that is family friendly with a little bit of a holiday flair to it.
Oh, that's nice.
So it'll make it fit in really nice with
now,
the
holiday flair you added, or was that part of the mega musical?
There's a couple of things in the mega musical that invite local celebrities. So we have our local celebrities coming as a holiday flair.
Oh, okay. Very
so that's
good.
We're looking forward to it. We've been working on this show for a while. And it's a really...
Well, maybe you want to give them a little bit of the history.
Of the Sisters of Hoboken?
Well, no, not the Sisters of...
Oh, you mean the
Just in that, originally...
Okay, I will.
Reading Community Players was going to do this show when?
We had originally planned on doing this show in June.
And that's why you said June.
That's why it was like...
It wasn't a senior moment.
Well, it's long-term memory that is, you know, kind of interferes with my short-term memory. Yes, we had hoped to do this show in June. We had hoped actually to do a different show. We were planning on doing a musical that was a family musical. And we just didn't get the numbers of people that we needed to have. So we kind of like switched gears and decided to do Nunsense because it is a show that many of the people in our cast have wanted to do in the past. I've done the show many times, so it was okay. So we were going gung-ho to do it in June, and we had an issue with ticket sales. And because Reading Community Player does not have their own space,
right,
we have to go and rent space, which is a costly thing. And so because our ticket sales weren't that strong, we needed to decide, we canceled the show and we postponed it, and we're doing it in December now instead. So,
well, things look up now, don't they?
Yes, they are.
Okay,
they are,
very good.
Yes. So,
excellent.
I mean, really, really happy about it, and we're ready to go, and we're ready to get move into Perkins and get things going there, and it'll be a fun night. It's if you've never experienced a Nunsense show, you don't need to be Catholic to understand it, but if you are, you'll understand it a lot better. And of course, nuns in today's society are not as strict, I guess, as what they were at one time. And we do wear habits. So we will look a lot different than we normally look.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, I'm excited, and we're all ready to do this. So,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
That's great.
So, but, so please come out and join us.
You have kids in it?
Yes, we do.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay.
Oh, now everybody knows. No, that's okay. Then that's perfectly okay.
I hope I didn't let the cat out of the bag.
Yes. Well, you know, I talked about the fact that we had some local celebrities.
Uh-huh.
Oh, there we go.
That's local celebrities.
Yes, yeah.
That's great.
So come out and enjoy that weekend before Christmas when you have everything decorated and all your cookies are baked and you just want to sit back and relax and laugh. Come and join us for Nunsense the Mega Musical.
Okay, it should be a lot of fun,
it is.
Right?
Yes, thank you.
Okay. So once again, I want to thank BCTV for allowing us this opportunity to promote the shows for the local community theaters that are doing Christmas shows this year, which is, it's wonderful because like I was saying to Jeanette, you know, last year there was one show, right. One Christmas show. That was it,
mm-hmm.
And which is remarkable. I mean, because really, we've got a lot of talent. We've got a lot of local theaters. Once again, I will say we need a community theater for people to be at and to have places to rehearse and places to store things and keep sets and do designing, teach young people how to do technical things. Building sets, costumes, it goes on and on. Like Jeanette was sharing with us that they need help backstage with the crew. Are you finding an issue with that?
Yes, especially when, like with Nunsense, there's no set changes. It all takes place in one location. But when you have a show and you have to change sets, you need to have a crew. You need to have someone to do that. In many cases, if you have simple set changes, you can do that with a cast,
uh-huh.
That you don't necessarily need to have a set, but you need somebody running on the lights and somebody running the sound and just somebody helping build the set, move the set in. There are so many things that go on behind the scenes that most audience members don't really know about.
No, they don't.
And young people... Those young people that are in high school need to start learning that there's more to theater than just being on stage.
Yeah.
I know at Berks Catholic, it's funny because Berks Catholic always has a huge stage crew. We sometimes have more kids on the stage crew than we do on the stage, which is a really great experience because they're back there running the lights, they're back there running the sound, and then they're moving furniture. So, I mean, it's a great thing for kids to get involved in. You don't necessarily have to be on stage
to be
in theater.
But you're a very important part
extremely
of that show.
Extremely important.
And
extremely
I think
important.
That's such a good aspect to share with people because you have the people that are on stage that enjoy performing, are not nervous and anxious. And
then you've got those people that are backstage supporting them. And so
absolutely,
we need those kinds of people to be involved even with local community theater. We need those people that aren't really wanting to be on stage but would like to help out and to be there and just to support what's going on stage. And it becomes a community. When you have somebody there all the time, you get to know new people and work with new people. And
make new friends.
That's right. And the collaboration that goes on in theater is a very strong one.
Yes, it is. And a lot of times you develop relationships and friendships that last for years and years.
Yep.
So, we're really fortunate that way in Berks County in that we have a very strong theater base. I mean, Reading Community Players will be 100 years old next year. Reading Civic Theater has been around for 107 plus years, I believe. There's such a community and such a talent here that it's wonderful to see everybody working together. And we'd even have it more coordinated and supportive if we had a community theater. I know that
we sound like a broken record.
We
need a community theater. We need a building. We need a space.
With a parking lot.
Yes, that would be even more wonderful. You know, it's just something that, I mean, Genesius has their own space. That gives them the opportunity to do what they can do when they want to do it.
Right, and they can do it for 2 weekends, which when we had our own theater, we used to do the shows for two weekends.
Yes.
So it would just be so nice to get a community theater together.
It would
be. We keep looking. We keep endeavoring. We haven't given up.
That's right.
But it is a challenge.
It is a very big challenge.
Yeah.
And we've been working on this for a long time.
Yeah, we have for quite a few years. It's one of the main goals and purposes of the Greater Reading Alliance of Community Theaters to support all the local community theaters, which is what we tried to do today with our little BCTV theater commercial.
Chatting outside.
Oh, my, yeah. Well, it's because it's so important. You know, these groups wouldn't exist if it weren't for the community and for our audience. Mm-hmm. So it's vital.
So we need you.
We do.
We
so don't be shy. If you don't want to be on stage, that's all right. We'll find something for you to do backstage. There's all sorts of things that people can learn to do that are part of an important part of a performance, costumes, makeup, props, set design, set pieces, all sorts of things. And it all works together to make a great show.
Absolutely.
So I want to thank you, Debbie,
well,
for being
you,
on TV
us.
With us. And I want to thank everybody else that came on, Bill, Nicole, Ruth, Susan, Jeanette, everybody,
Brian,
and wish them all well. And break a leg, as we say in the theater.
Yes.
Have some good shows.
Happy holidays, everyone.
Yeah, Merry Christmas, happy holidays. Happy, healthy New Year, everybody. And we'll see you next year on Greater Reading Act Up with some more theater information. So thank you for tuning in, and bless you.
Greater Reading ACT UP on BCTV is supported by the Greater Reading Alliance of Community Theaters.